If you say what you want to say, then let the words fall out.
Hi, I'm Nadia McInnes, and welcome to You Are Gifted. Today, I'm going to talk to you about a topic that's dear to my heart, and it's about leadership and character. Yes, leadership and character. And I'm going to start this topic with a quote from the late Dr. Miles Monroe, and I'm going to read it. He said, "The foundation of leadership is character." You heard that right. The foundation of leadership is character. Not power, not skill, not influence, not competence, but character. The greatest protection of leadership is character. Talents and gifts are only as safe as your character. You heard that? Your talents and your gifts are only as safe as your character. I know I always talk about using your gift and being gifted and how to maximize it and turn your gift into a business and all that. But remember, your talents and your gifts are only as safe as your character. So let's go back to the first thing that Dr. Miles said. He said, "The foundation of leadership is character." And I tell you, this for me is so powerful, because this one statement from the late Dr. Miles Monroe has transformed my entire life. You know, there was a point in my life where I used to believe that once people have certain titles, they're automatically a leader and a good leader, until I found out that that is not true. So now what I do, I look at people's character, thanks to Dr. Miles Monroe, because I have discovered that anybody can get up and say, you know what, in 2 months' time, I'm going to start a church. In 3 months' time, I'm going to become a pastor. In 5 months' time, I am now an apostle. After a year, I am now a prophet. But when you look at the character of that person, everything about them, what they say, what they do, where they go, how they talk, is the opposite of that of a pastor, is the opposite of that of a prophet, is the opposite of that of an apostle. And because of Dr. Miles Monroe, who came into my life and let me understand that your gift is only as safe as your character, and that the foundation of leadership is character, I don't have that belief anymore, that if someone walks up to me and say, I'm an apostle, I'm an a prophet, I need to know your character. I need to know who you are. I need to know how you treat people. I need to know how you react to things. And that has transformed how I relate to people, who I call leaders. So for me now, personally, you'll never see me going around and say, oh, this great MOG, man of God, this great apostle. No, 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 no. I'm going to look at your character. I'm going to look at the way you treat your wife. I'm going to look at the way you treat your members. I'm going to look at the way you treat people who has offended you. I'm going to look at the way you treat your members when they leave your church. I'm going to look if you're a bully, if you are a professional manipulator, as Dr. Miles Monroe calls them. You see, a lot of people that we are calling leaders, that we are calling pastors, they're actually professional manipulators. And I personally have come to accept and realize that this is true. So I'm going to put the link to Dr. Miles Monroe's video underneath this video, and I'm going to encourage you to watch it and to listen, because he said so much and he's been saying so much for me to come here and try to interpret and say everything to you. But I want to encourage you to look at people's character when they call themselves pastors, for you to start going to them and opening up to them and telling them your issues. These people can use these things against you, because some are genuinely professional manipulators. There's a young, he calls himself prophet from America, a young pastor, a young guy who I respect. I remember when we had the election with between Hillary and Donald Trump, he prophesied that Hillary would win. And when Hillary didn't win, I remember this guy came live on Facebook. I can't remember his name, and I don't want to call his name either because maybe he doesn't want me to talk about it. He said on Facebook Live that, guys, I made a mistake. I lost it. I got it wrong. And you will not be hearing from me anytime soon. And to be honest, I've never seen him again on Facebook. And let me tell you something. I respect that man. I respect that man so much. He was so dignified. He had so much integrity, good character to come forward to say, I made a mistake. I lost it. I got it wrong. I am going back to pray and see where I've gone wrong. And let me tell you why I respect him. And I believe that he is a true prophet who got it wrong. But he was honest enough to come forward and say, I made a mistake, and he disappeared. I saw cases where other so-called MOGs who call themselves men of God, who prophesy wrongly daily, even in the midst of this crisis that's going on. And instead of coming and say, I got it wrong, I made a mistake, which would cause me and several others to respect them more. Do you know what they do? They come and they lie. They twist it. They said, oh, I prayed and God changed it. Or that's not what I meant. Or it was meant for UK, not Canada. It was meant for Africa, not the Caribbean. You know, all these things, and they mess with me. And to me, those are the fake. Those are the full fake pastors. Those are the ones that are professional manipulators that people need to run away from. So I am encouraging you, if you've got a leader, are people you are calling your mentors, don't just look at how powerful they are. Don't just look at how much influence you think they have, or how much followers you think they have, or the miracles that you think they are working. Look at their character. Do they constantly lie without repentance? I'm not talking about people who make mistakes here and there. I told you about the prophet in America. He made his mistake, and he came forward. And for me, I respect him more for that. I respect him more for that. Do they constantly try to bully you or manipulate you or push you aside if you don't do what they want to do? You know, I remember there was also this other apostle who from Nigeria, who claimed that he's an apostle, and a big scandal came out about him, and there was evidence, a lot of evidence that proved that the woman was not lying. And I remember hearing that man, you know, he went on camera in front of his church to his members, and he said, if there's anyone who's sitting here and you believe it, you should leave, and you should have no position. You should never have any position in this church. You are not even worthy to be here. Remove them immediately. Remove them. And I was like, whoa, you are a bully. You are a false prophet. You are a professional manipulator. You are the leader without character. And it really grieved my heart when I see people calling these people great men of God, MOG, touching at the Lord's anointing. You are not the Lord's anointed because you decide that you are now a pastor. You are not the Lord's anointed because you decide that you are now an apostle. Your character, we tell us, the Bible says, by their fruits you shall know them. And it's not talking about how much miracle they work, or how many followers they have, or how much money they can deceive out of people. It's how do they live their life? How do they react to situation? You know what I use as my standard to judge these people? Jesus Christ, who I follow. Jesus Christ. How do Jesus Christ relate to things? Of course, Jesus was not so quiet. Jesus would challenge people and say, oh, you hypocrites, if this. But look at the life he lived. Look at the life he lived. You can't come and accuse him of anything that, you know, this thing is out of morals, unless you be lying. And I use Jesus to judge these so-called men of God, whether or not they are leaders, not because they say so. Because if you think about it, I could get up tomorrow and say, as of now, I am a prophetess. And I start calling myself Prophetess Nadia. That's a lie. Who ordains me? Is it God? Who says so? And even if I was ordained, maybe I was ordained by another fake, another professional manipulator. You know, so it's good to look at people's character. Sorry, in fact, I am not sorry, but you're not going to get me under any of these so-called MOGs, as they call themselves, men of God, who, when I look at the way they treat their wives, when I look at the way they treat their children, when I look at the way they treat their members, when I look at the way they come at YouTubers who talk the truth about them and show evidence, when I look at the way they attack people and threaten people instead of addressing the issue and say, you know, they said this, but this was what happened, when they push it aside and say, because of who I am, you shouldn't say, I know I'm dealing with a professional manipulator. I know I'm dealing with someone who just decided that I'm going to start a church. And you know, it's not only pastors, you've got mentors as well. Mentors who just want to say, oh, I'm a coach, I am a this and I am a that. But really, really, the people who are following you, the people who are your mentees, are you really helping them? Or are you just manipulating them? So this video is really about, you know, who do you call leaders? Who do you call leaders? Don't just respect someone because of their title, or because of how educated they are, or because of how much followers they are. Look at their character. How do they treat people? How do they talk to people? When people have evidence against them, do they threaten them with touching at the Lord's anointing, or do you know who I am? Or do they address the specific issue and say, this, they said this, but take a look at this? Or do they bully them and say, oh, you can't be anything in here, don't come here if you can't follow our instruction, or this was what happened, and this is how we're going to deal with it. So you really have to look at the character of people that you call in leaders. Are they your leaders, or are they professional manipulators? Are they really men of God, or are they men who decide that I'm gonna start a church and call myself a man of God? They don't deserve your respect. They don't deserve your respect. Good, honest people are quick and ready to say, I made a mistake, I got it wrong, and this is what I'm going to do from now on. And those people are easier to follow. So check who your leaders, and always remember that you are gifted. If you say what you want to say.